So what we have here is an assessment of our wall. Everyone knows the 9/11 wall right now is in disrepair. And this is the second time that it's happened. If you read over this 17-page report, you're going to see that this wall is probably not worth repairing again. Okay, and that's really what we're coming down to. We're trying to look at what we can do in the future to create some kind of a 9/11 memorial. And one of the things that has been, I've been in touch with several of the fire departments too, and they understand that we are in a situation now where we would be pouring money into possibly a wall that might fall again. Or the, and we're not sure we can save the tiles. If you look at the photos, the backs of the tiles are covered with different kinds of adhesives that would crack when we're taking them apart. So I wanted everyone to take a look at this to see, and it's a good snapshot of where we are with the wall at this point. I was talking to CJ earlier today, and I have something else I'd like to hand out, which is a picture from above of the wall.
You sent this to Francis?
No, I did not. I just came up with this one right
here. All right, I'm going to hold this one for you, Francis, and I'll put it in the packet.
Yeah. All right. And you can view this, Francis, by just looking at Google Earth. It looks down, straight down on top of the wall, and you'll see that there are two small sidewalks that approach the wall. The wall itself is surrounded by a sidewalk. And I spoke to Bobby Breen today, and I also spoke to DPW about this, and we could in-house remove the wall and remove many of the sidewalks that are around that area. In-house, okay? And then the sidewalk that's at the top of the picture is the one nearest to the flagpole. Mm-hmm. That might be a place where we could put something smaller, something a little more, in line with that area. Leave that sidewalk there. I've included some photos of memorials from around the United States. Some even from different countries that they put up over 9/11 that included and incorporated a piece of the metal, which we have there, that might be something we might want to look at. I'm trying to come up with some ideas here. I don't think that the last time I spoke with John Malone, who's a former fire captain at Fairview, and I spoke to Ray Maceda today, who's the chief for Hartsdale. I think they're in line with trying to downsize this memorial to something that, doesn't cost as much. To rehab the wall would be well over $100,000.
So in terms of if we do something smaller there,
mm-hmm.
What would we do? Basically have like a competition and say, we want to and maybe ask the artists if they could incorporate some of the tiles or
If you look at the report, the tiles are in such disrepair, I'm not sure that we can salvage them. That's the problem. Even cleaning the tiles cracks them at this point because they have so many adhesives on the back of them. And just look at those pictures at the back. That's one of the things I really wanted to be able to make sure that you understood is that this is it's a dire situation when it comes to some of these things. And maybe we should just, at this point, just move in a different direction.
You know what happens with the adhesives? They are different compositions, and they take moisture differently. So, that's problematic in and of itself, and can cause the cracking because of the expansion and reduction in those.
Yeah, I think everything you said sort of makes sense because we built the wall. It didn't
2003.
Last. Yeah, we tried restoring it.
2008.
Right. So we basically made an effort, and I think the problem is it's an eyesore now. So I think before the coming 9/11, if we could figure out something that would be appropriate, that doesn't even have to be at that location because we have the 9/11 memorial. At the multi-purpose center, so we could
the Gerard Byrne Center,
right? Yeah, Right. So we could basically, you know, even put the metal, the World Trade artifact, you know, there.
That's actually, you know, and when I spoke to some of the, you know, the fire chiefs and also, you know, John Malone and some of the people on our advisory board, they thought that was appropriate too, because that's as a place to put a memorial, because we've been using it now for the last 2 years. But we're, I'm just trying to give some options here so that the board can take a look at this, because obviously, you know, I'm not an artist. I'm not a sculptor. I just wanted to come up with some ideas that maybe you could look at and take, and whether or not we bring in artists, I'm not really sure how that has worked in the past.
A couple of things. Number one, just so that you know, there's a remnant also in Croton.
Okay.
And it's very impressive. I mean, of course, it's near the water, but it is impressive and something you can look up. The other thing is that the importance, I think, to survivors, families of survivors, is having a place to go and see. There is something to be said for having it off Main Road, easily visible and visitable. But if it's, as you said, you know, we've created, but that's more our immediate town and rather not even town-wide, but veterans and so forth. So, you know, it's also promoting that as a site and giving it the aura of a respectful, respected memorial that people feel that they can contemplate. Just and so it's also creating the, you know, seating, whether it's benches or something around it. So just think in the macro and how that is. I'm not advocating one or the other, but whatever it is that we do, not just positioning a piece of sculpture, but creating a whole site story.
Oh, I totally agree with you. I mean, no matter, you know, most of these pictures that you're going to see, if you pulled back and seen, you'll see there are benches around them so that people that, you know, are affected by this want to sit there and they can contemplate, you know. And we've had, I think we had 5 or 6 people in the town of Greenberg that actually lost their lives that we actually have on a plaque at the Gerard Byrne Center that are on some stones there that we've had since the actual, you know, 9/11. So we can always relocate those things, but I just, you know, this is a tough, I feel like this is a tough conversation to have. You know, we've had this memorial up there now for 20 plus years at this point. Some of those tiles that those children did, if they were 10 years old at the time, they're probably 31 years old now. So we've lost a lot, but I think it's what we're seeing here is it, and I even spoke with CJ, and he looked over this too. I think it's time to move on from this particular memorial to something maybe a little smaller, you know, that we can put, and where we put it, we're not really sure. I'm just giving you, I mean, two options right off the bat are either right there by the flagpole at Presser Park or perhaps over at the Gerard Burns.
Another thing that I feel we could do, what the county's done, and yeah, to the memorial, some of the people who lost their lives years later. You know, you've had people in the fire department who have passed away.
First responders.
So we could expand on that. And if you use the Jerry Byrne Center, we could even have photos of the original memorial. You know, so this way we're in some ways maintaining. You know, so this way people could see the historical. The history of it, so we could say this is what happened, and there could be a wall with displaying the murals, and then if there's, you know, in fact, maybe if an artist could even use some of the existing murals for an art exhibit on the wall there, and I'd say probably to me, probably the best location would be really the Jerry Byrne Center.
You know, I think we can determine that. Let's just because there are people listening or who will listen to this, once it's on video, this report is very thorough. I really commend the person who did the inspections and the research and really went into detail, not only about the wall's history and composition, but the whys and wherefores that it isn't necessarily recommended to reuse the tiles. And she took a number of photos. We can post it on our site so that you can see the deterioration. She looked very carefully at everything, and I really commend her for the work that she did, and I thank her.
She was quite professional. We went hand in hand together to all the locations. You know, she interviewed us all about the history. We went through quite a process to make sure that we got a thorough snapshot of where we are right now, so that we can make decisions from moving forward.
Hal wanted to ask, why can't the tiles be mounted on an intermediary backing and then the backing be screwed into the wall and the whole thing covered by glass or lucite? Is that something?
Well, we talked about doing frames at one point.
We did talk about it, but we also found out that we really don't know what the composition of the wall itself is. Mm-hmm. So there would have to be an engineering report just to find out if the wall, what's inside of it, because we don't have records of the wall building. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. And if I may respond directly to that question, in order to mount it, you have to clean the surface of the back surface of the tile so that they can be remounted. But as the commissioners, how are you going to have them?
Hal doesn't really
frame each single one.
He hasn't seen the tiles, and I think when we post this online, he can understand that the backing, the pictures that are in this. Are representative of most of the tiles that have multiple surfaces and multiple adhesives and cements and epoxies on the back of them that in the removal process would probably break the tiles themselves.
Well, I think what Hal is sort of saying is that you don't have to, like, you can have those layers and maybe still adhere, so it would be like some are more.
Well, but you see, if you have the backing on the individual tiles, number one, that it's uneven. Mm-hmm. So it's not just in bas relief, but it's how you could really secure them. And it's also, there has to be some level of handling, and they're fragile. So we don't even know the best laid plans.
They could start and they could just fall apart.
Yes. Yes. So
I think money needs to.
Can we please stop having outbursts from the ground, please?
We need to consider how expensive this is going to be. I know that's something that needs to be talked about here. To refurbish the wall itself would be quite expensive. Okay, it's a big piece of cement. And the top is coming off. It's leaking. It's coping. It's leaking inside. We don't feel that the wall itself is really worth saving. So where are you going to put the tiles? You know. So that's one of the reasons we might want to think about moving on to something smaller.
But you could do something smaller and maybe utilize the tiles that are sturdy enough to create some other object of art that is used in either there or
Correct.
In a different place.
You know, Correct.
One at the Jerry Byrne Center.
I'm open to any of this. All this are great ideas. Yeah. I just don't know where do we go from here if we now have this, if we agree that the wall itself probably is not the way to go.
Mm-hmm.
So why don't we?
That's what I hear.
That's really what's before us.
Yeah.
Right.
That's what I'm
hearing. Are we accepting a report? And the report is very comprehensive, but it could be summarized very simply as the wall is hopeless.
Right.
Well, this is where CJ comes in, and it's a matter of the engineering and the engineering inspection to Francis. Right. I didn't mean to cut you off.
According to the report, they don't even know what's in the wall. They don't know
Right.
the rebar. They don't know anything about it.
Right.
But they do know that the significant damage to the moisture, and moisture and concrete don't go well.
Right.
And I do like and what was handed out, and thank you for we do have a piece of metal. One of the things I really would like to have done is to have the piece of metal that we have at Prescott Park be placed on the National Register. And apparently that's not happened, according to the report. So I don't know why, but I assume it's legit. We've been out there for quite a long time. And if it is, it should be recognized as such.
Well,
one of the pictures at the very end where it says World Trade Center and it has a piece of metal. It's really impressive. I mean, we have to obviously do everything we can to honor and respect what that metal represents.
May I ask a question, Francis? When you talk about being on the registry, is it the sculpture at the site itself, or is it the sculpture alone? Sculpture, the piece of metal itself that we rescue.
The artifacts from 9/11, apparently, according to the report, there's a registry that has been created for those. And she notes in her report that this is not.
Well, says
right.
The Rotary not Club. The Rotary Club's paid for the wall. The back of the wall had, descriptions of Rotary and, all that. And I'm sort of wondering if we should reach out to the Rotary group as well, because, I have good relationships with the Rotary, clubs. The district governor is active in Elmsford. And I sort of think that if we had a meeting with maybe the handful of firefighters, who were involved at U McCallie, the Rotary groups, then we can make a decision and then move on.
There are other ways of handling that too, in terms of the Rotary Club, if they want to. It might not be the wall. For instance, in Hastings, there's a site, a Revolutionary War site, and they created a park, a small little parklet, and they created stanchions with storyboards, basically, but it could as easily be some sort of depiction as there as was on the wall. There are any number of ways to reimagine. They don't have to be linked, is what
I'm
saying.
That's actually a great idea. You could have a story walk, and then it could sort of highlight, we could highlight people's impressions. We could highlight some of the mural, take photos, and people could walk around, a story walk. The Nature Center has that. There could be a little walking area, and then you could mount.
Well, these are great ideas, but I think, as you suggested, it would be good to have a meeting, and that's the time to start.
And bring in, an art consultant.
I could contact the Rotary people.
That's fine. I just want to make sure that we focus on 9/11, not the Rotary.
Right.
Thank you.
Okay.
I just want to separate them. Not that they don't want to contribute.
If I could, Joe, the report also addresses the poor condition of the Rotary side.
Right.
Right.
It's not just the tiles coming off. They're painting. Apparently, they didn't use paint that's designed for outdoors.
Right.
And it's showing the effects of that. So the whole thing is
We'll turn it into a positive, and I just wonder, but I had a in the spirit.
If we do meet with the Rotary, I just kind of want to know that I'm getting the sense from the board, without any kind of a vote or anything, that we're okay with moving past the wall if possible.
I didn't hear what you said.
We're okay with looking at alternatives to the wall. Okay.
I think that's important.
Okay. I think it is.
What is that?
Paul's playing the wall song. Oh. Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay.
Did you see anybody?
Correct.
Say Hayden's
Town? Yeah, I agree. Should you, Francis?
Okay, that's I guess.
Why is that music?
No, that was
Paul's the DJ tonight. His latest song.
That was from Hayden's Town. Why We Build a Wall.
As long as he doesn't get up and dance.
Our fearless leader.
On the table.
On the table. Right.
No, I think this is great.
Okay.
I think, Joe, would, you know, get the meeting together.
Sure.
Here, you've heard everyone. I think that, you know, we're definitely looking for alternatives that's
right.
really going to be long-lasting. So,
right.
you know,
yeah,
I like the thing that, I'll be very honest, I love what's at the Kensico Dam that the county did. I think
yeah.
that is just so beautiful. Maybe you can have something similar. I don't
right.
know. I know it's costly,
no,
but,
know.
You know, but I think that is really a great trip.
I do, too. I think that's, you know, like, well, it is the county. You know, which is the big,
right,
but
right.
I'm, you know, I included
you know
I, some of the small things that you saw in the papers I gave you were Dobbs Ferry has a plaque. Irvington has two granite pillars at the end.
Yeah.
They're tasteful. They're
and,
you know, obviously they're in great locations on the river. I mean,
right.
we don't have that, but I do know that we have some nice places mm-hmm. and that if we do choose to go back to Presser Park and we find something that's really tasteful,
mm-hmm.
we can really make it look nice.
I like the accessibility of it because
yeah.
it's like you just drive by it all the time. It's
right.
it's like very much part of the town
yeah.
as opposed
right.
to the Burn Center, which is
yeah.
up and tucked away.
Right, right, which is what
right
I was
away,
saying
really
earlier.
Really
yeah.
Take the
yeah.
feel of it. Yeah.
And,
right.
and we also
yeah.
have the, when we reached out to the World Trade Center, you know, the organization that was giving out the artifacts,
right.
I think we did say that we're going to use it at this location.
Oh, yeah.
So
I think the artifact that we have, and look into what you're asking, Francis, which is why it's not on the registry, because I may have to go to Sarah Bracy White and ask her because I think she was instrumental in helping us to get that stuff at the beginning.
We could right. I think this is fine. So why don't I'll reach out to the Rotary Club because they
okay.
indicated they were willing to pay for, you know, a good chunk.
Oh.
You know, and make this like a cause, and I'll say, listen,
right.
you know, we want to basically continue. To honor the Rotary Club for memorializing the victims of 9/11,
sure.
and we just want, you know, we don't want it to be an eyesore, and we want to move ahead, and would like to have a meeting, and then I could let all the board members know when we're meeting, and then I think Chip Nanko we should really reach out to, and
okay.
John Malone,
yeah.
And I'll do that.
Also, really quickly, so if we think about relocating that. The wall or whatever we're going to do with it, we should probably put a plaque for those who participated in the first original wall
right.
or the Rotary Clubs that
oh, yeah,
participated.
Yeah.
Have a plaque dedicated
sure.
to them because they were instrumental
Great
in the
idea.
Original.
Well, if you look at, I don't even know if it's in this report, but there are plaques up there right now.
Yeah, that's
we're not going to be getting rid of those.
Oh, so
okay.
you can repurpose
they, we
those.
Could,
mm-hmm.
We could repurpose those
yeah.
and
okay.
make sure that they become part of whatever we do in the future.
Yeah. Right. The other thing, the other possible location could be the town hall, like outside over here, because
no, but
well, again, it's not
that's
as
off
public
the
a spot.
Track. Yeah,
right.
You know. Used to coming there.
Yeah, I do. And I just one last thing I just want to mention is that this has probably come out wrong. I was never a fan of the wall because I would like to see green space open up on Central Avenue.
Uh-huh.
Presser Park was this wonderful piece of green space that's the only place that you see that on Central Avenue. If we make the wall smaller or
yeah.
make something smaller, you will then be able to view that again.
Uh-huh.
Okay?
Yeah.
And so I just thought that, you know, this is a double win if we get it right.
Okay.
Okay.
I'd like to ask a question.
Sure.
I think we, as board members, all understand and accept that the wall is something that we can't use. So I just wanted to let CJ off the hook unless you wanted to hear what his impressions of the wall were.
Well, CJ gonna say it's not good. No.
yeah, I agree.
Just bring your mic if you're gonna speak.
Yeah. I agree. If we try to repair the wall and reuse the tiles, eventually in a few years we're gonna be in the same position having the same conversations again.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you. So does that mean that we should begin that process of moving the tiles?
I think we have
the tiles
have been moved already.
Right.
The tiles have been removed, and if you look at the report in the back of the report, they're all in boxes
and
they're crates, and they're
right.
just being stored away, which is the same thing we did in 2008 when they fell off, too.
Right.
So what happens to the tiles may or may not have anything to do with what happens to a new repurposed memorial, right?
Right. No, but I mean,
but
can you start demolishing the wall now? Is that like something
we're
going to go
ahead right away,
with?
But
we should reach
should
out to the
plan,
Rotary
though.
Club.
I think we need to have a whole plan.
And everybody, the
yeah.
firefighters, and get
yeah.
buy-in from a larger group, so this way nobody will say, what did you do? Why did you do
oh,
it? So,
yeah, of course,
so
all
I
this.
Think that's,
I agree with what Paul just said. We get the buy-in, and then we take the wall down, and we, you know, replace it with, you know, grass there in that spot. And then we talk about whether or not we want to use the end of it. Because there, as you look at as you look down on the wall, you'll see two little stubby sidewalks that come off the main sidewalk. Well, the one on the far end we would probably not keep, but the one that's over closer to the flagpole, where we speak at that end, that might be worth keeping. Right. And so then you would have a way to get from the sidewalk then to the
Yeah. Right. So I think it's really developing the larger plan and then moving ahead
right.
with the different steps, removing
right.
the wall.
At this point right now, we've painted the wall gray to try and not draw as much attention to it. But I talked to Bobby Breen today, and he said, the day you want to take the wall down, he goes, will not be a problem. He goes, well, we could take it down pretty fast. Yeah. Okay?
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Another possible location could be the library. Because it's very visible. They already, right now, they have the World War, the Women's Veterans Memorial. They did that about 2 years.
The garden, which is
right.
beautiful.
So the thing is, yeah. So many people use that, and the people who go to the library may want an area that they could reflect and think about 9/11. You know, to me, the veteran part, the web field, mm-hmm. it's really, you know, there's not a lot of people go there to play soccer or play cricket, sure. you know, then or go to the playground. So I feel the library, or to me, Veteran Park, or here might be even more appropriate. But that could be for the committee to just
sure.
decide.
Yeah. But, you know, that's a good idea. You know, there were years when I first moved here that I'd drive by and I'd see this and I'd say, well, that's interesting, but I didn't know what it was
right.
and what it, because I was driving by.
Yeah.
And I don't know how many people really walk along the
right,
sidewalk
that's correct.
There. So it is something to consider.
And remember, the library also has a history archives. So the thing is, we could, they have an archive room. So we could even give the boxes, you know, to them. And if people want to look at the murals that were painted, it could be a place where it could be stored. And then they could even have a wall where they basically are highlighting the history of the wall and say, by the way, if you want to see the originals, you make an appointment
right.
and see the. So that's another way of providing
well,
dignity
I think
to
well,
I think Paul,
I think
you
this
should
group.
Be part of that committee.
Yeah,
so,
you should be part of that.
Just to give you a little bit more of the history, when we first put in the wall in 2003, there was no sidewalk on Central Avenue, mm. okay? And so it was just a wall there, and it was nice. But that sidewalk that you see, we got a grant, and the board backed us at the time. And one of the things that we felt at the time, and this is funny because this is all about sidewalks, we thought, wow, we're getting a sidewalk on Central Avenue. And anybody that's ever walked on Central Avenue knows it's very difficult to navigate that piece of land, you know, to heading up and down north and south there. So that sidewalk will always be there, where no matter where we take, you know, this memorial.
Right.
That's good. So I'll work on it. Right. Tonight, so you may get an email.
I always get. I always get an email late at night from
thank
you, Paul.
You.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
Thanks.
So much.
Thank you.
All right. All right.